I try to convince people to slow down AI. Nobody listens.
No one.
A report by OpenAI, the company who created ChatGPT, claims that 80% of total jobs will be impacted by AI. And this impact is going to be very different from the Industrial Revolution or the Internet. Because the Industrial Revolution and Internet just reshuffled the workforce. AI can eliminate the workforce altogether. For me to sit here and pretend that I as a programmer would never be impacted by AI would be very arrogant of me. Over the past few months, I have talked to many of my colleagues about this subject. In this video, I want to tell you everything that I've learned so far. I'll also share how you can upskill yourself as a programmer and survive this AI revolution. This video is going to be very critical for your future. So
pay attention.
Those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it. To understand what AI might do to the current job market, we need to go back in time to the 18th century. The Industrial Revolution is at its peak. Machines such as steam engines and power looms are replacing manual labor in various industries. Many agricultural laborers and textile workers are losing their jobs. Instead of working on their own land or in small workshops, workers now find themselves in large factories, operating machines and working in assembly lines. Workers are assigned specific tasks within the production process, leading to increased specialization and increased productivity and efficiency. This new group of workers, which include managers, professionals, and skilled workers, led to the creation of a new social class known as the middle class. Before the revolution, there were only two classes, the wealthy elite and the poor working class. Here are two things that I want you to take away from this. Number one, the Industrial Revolution led to the creation of the middle class. Number two, Industrial Revolution led to increased specialization. I'm sure most of you can guess how AI revolution is going to be very similar to the Industrial Revolution. But for programmers, it's the difference between the Industrial Revolution and the AI revolution that is much more important. So let's dig into it a little bit. Let's divide the programmers into three different groups or classes. At the very bottom, we have people who have very basic programming skills. For example, these could be people who can make basic portfolio websites or write simple SQL queries for databases. Above them are the programmers who can build slightly more complex features. Code bases these people work on are bigger, and the features they build require more server-side work. In a way, these programmers are the middle class of the programming world. Above them at the very top are the programmers who work on huge code bases. They are usually responsible for products that need scale because they serve millions of users. These programmers slash software engineers need to think about the architecture and the different trade-offs that come with it. These would be your senior or principal engineers at big tech companies. It's my hypothesis that if AI keeps advancing at the current rate, and there's a big if there, the programmer middle class would disappear, which is exactly the opposite of what Industrial Revolution did. And if you happen to fall in the bottom tier of programmers and you are feeling lucky, I'm afraid it's not a good news for you as well. Please allow me to explain this. Until today, we have needed some sort of language to instruct computers what to do. And that's why we have developed so many different programming languages to serve different applications. We have languages like Python that's heavily used in machine learning and JavaScript that's used to build websites. But with the recent advancements in AI, English, and all these other languages can be understood by computers and have sort of become new programming languages. You can simply tell ChatGPT what you're trying to build in plain English, and it spits out the code you need to build it. What this means is that anyone who can explain things well and has basic programming skills to verify the code spit out by AI can build things for which we needed the programmer middle class. That's why I believe that the middle tier of programmers would vanish and merge with these bottom tier programmers. And in terms of salary, this bottom tier would actually sit lower than where it sits right now. That's because there are so many people who can write well, creating a lot of competition for a limited number of jobs, which would lower the salaries. This should not come as a surprise, because as AI and automation take on more and more jobs, humans would have to work less and less. And work is what creates value. With most people not working, the society will become more egalitarian, which isn't really a bad thing. What about these people at the top? Why are they making so much more than the others? Well, if AI keeps advancing, we would not need any of these classes. Nobody would be working, and we'll all get what our governments would decide to pay us. I apologize if I've scared you. It was not my intention. All of this is speculation, and we are still very far from the scenario I just described. But the chances of this happening are far from zero. So I'm not going to let you leave here without any solution. So if you're a budding programmer, how can you survive the AI revolution? When one door closes, another opens. But we often look so long upon the closed door that we miss the one that just opened. While AI might lead to job losses in some areas, it's also expected to create new job opportunities. The AI revolution will require skilled workers who can develop, implement, and maintain AI systems. Jobs related to machine learning and robotics are expected to see increased demand. What this means is that AI revolution is also going to lead to increased specialization, but in the fields that I just mentioned. And who do you think is in the best position to upskill themselves and take on these jobs? It's the programmers. To understand why that is, we need to know what it takes to build AI systems. Imagine that this big circle represents artificial intelligence, which is nothing but systems that imitate humans when it comes to thinking and action. There are many ways to achieve artificial intelligence, but the most common one is called machine learning. Within machine learning is a technique called deep learning. In deep learning, a machine gains artificial intelligence by using layers of interconnected neurons that's also called neural network. The name comes from the fact that these networks try to imitate how our brain functions with the help of interconnected neurons. These neural networks are at the core of building AI systems similar to ChatGPT. Programming is one of the many skills that are required to build and train neural networks. So we need programmers to build these systems. Additionally, programmers are the ones who design the infrastructure and frameworks required for deploying neural networks to ensure scalability and efficiency. That's why I believe that programmers are in the best position to benefit from the AI revolution. But as I mentioned, programming by itself is not enough. You need some other skills along with programming to be successful in the AI world. So what are these skills? The first skill you need is math. Linear algebra and calculus sit at the core of machine learning. Math is mostly needed to understand how different machine learning algorithms work. Once you have understood that, you can simply use pre-written machine learning models in Python. So unless you're building new machine learning algorithms, you don't really need to be a math genius to do all this stuff. Next, you need to have basic understanding of statistics. Theory behind machine learning concepts like bias variance trade-off and overfitting are rooted in statistics. Along with that, you also need programming. To be more specific, you would want to learn programming in Python. Next, you need to learn various machine learning techniques like linear regression and k-nearest neighbors, etc. And lastly, you need to learn deep learning algorithms like convolutional neural networks and transformers. ChatGPT is built using transformer architecture. I know this path looks very long and difficult, but if it helps you, I have completed both AI machine learning path and web development path, and I found AI path to be easier. I believe that if you're a programmer, you must spend some time learning about this AI path if you want to become future-proof. If you want to know how to learn all the things I mentioned using free resources online, watch this video. My name is Sahil, and I'll see you in the next one.